Hello, Twitch. How you doing? We're gonna make a video of Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls. Probably just do a little bit of adventure mode. Do a little bounty. Basically, I'm screwing around with some new settings. Just want to make. I'll be making a video here in a few days when the new season starts on Diablo 3. Like many people are going to be doing. Kadala.
Anything could happen.
Let's see. Let's do one-handed mystery weapon. Only required level 16. I don't know. How about this mystery orb? Mr. Chest Armor. Let's go ahead and see what we get for weapons.
What a steal.
It's not bad. Go ahead and run an Nephilim Rift.
Enemies of the Nephilim surround you.
For you people watching on Twitch, let me know what you think about the new season starting up on Diablo 3. I recently switched to electricity to electrocute instead of using spectral blades that I was using. So I've never used the electrocute before, and I'm not 100% sure what I think about it yet. It's doing that thing again where it won't let me attack. I've been having some problems. There we go. Been having some problems lately. I don't know what's going on, but I go to attack and my guy just freezes. Stays there. If you watcher is wondering what my build is, I don't have a build, so to say, but we'll go ahead and take a quick look and show you what I got. I just I'm running a wizard, level 70, paragon level 49, rare shoulders 958, Wizard's helmet, chest armor, legendary amulet, rare bracers, rare ring. If you haven't noticed, a lot of my stuff is regeneration of health. I am big on regeneration of health. This Chandoto's force I actually found 100% by accident, obviously. And it seems to be doing pretty good. I got my Imperial Gem in there to increase my critical hit. My follower, she's not doing too bad herself. She's got a rare staff. Done too many rifts, so I don't know how powerful my wizard is, how far she'd actually make it. I'm only doing hard mode, because for some odd reason my wizard is not doing as much damage as I'd like. I think I'm going to go back to Arcane Torrent. I didn't even realize that I didn't I didn't put a skill on that. I didn't do a very good job here. Oh, come on. do dominance. We'll go back to Spectral Blade. And then we'll do Ice Blades. Attack.
I'm just warming up.
Got some nice legendary boots. Those are some nice boots. Unfortunately, I can't use them. Like I was saying earlier, those of you watching, let me know what you think about season 8 coming up. I've never actually played a seasonal character yet, so it's something that's gonna be new to me. Take that emerald. We'll use it for when we craft better gems.
Need more arcane power.
As you see, I don't go flying through the rifts that fast. My guy just don't do that much damage. See some of those people on Format 10, level 10, and they're just flying through doing like one-hit kills and stuff. I don't understand how they get their characters to be so powerful. Granted, you look at their Paragon level and they're like hundreds and hundreds of levels up there. Or even 1,000. guy is taking some damage. Arcane Torrent. It seems to be pretty powerful. Kraken's Truss. I have a habit of my inventory being full all the time. I'm a hoarder. That should be an achievement. Hoarder or clean meat freak. Hoarder, if you constantly have your inventory full, or meat freak if your inventory is always nice and neat. Yeah, I usually don't run rifts because they take me forever to do one. As you can see, my character's not attacking. For you watchers that are new to Diablo 3, let me know what you think of Diablo 3 so far. I actually have a person I just added my friends list the other day that just bought Diablo 3 just a few days ago. So he's experiencing Diablo 3 for the first time, which would be nice. I mean, I remember when I first played Diablo 3, I enjoyed it. I've only been playing for a few months myself. Heard so many negative things about Diablo 3 and it made me not want to buy the game. Then I waited to get all the bugs out. I didn't have to wait as long as I did, but I did. Yeah, too many people ruined Diablo 3 for me for as long as they did. I should have just listened to myself and told myself it's a good game, because it is a good game. Do Nephilim riffs all day long, and I don't know how they do that. They get pretty boring after a while. I myself, I can only game in short spurts. Lately, I've been finding myself playing Diablo 3, you know, for hours again like I used to. I just can't game the way I used to. I used to game for hours and hours and hours and hours when I was younger, but I just don't do that anymore. I get older. Speaking of getting older, my 12-year-old son, he's got Diablo 3, and he really likes it. He's about a kid that can sit here and play games for hours. I remember the days when I was that young playing games for hours and hours and hours. It's kind of nice playing the Nephilim riffs every now and then. That way you get to look at different scenery that's not in the game itself. Of course, they show you parts of the game that are in the main game itself too. One thing I wish Diablo, well, I should say Blizzard, I wish the Blizzard company, I wish they'd let you do mods, because I can only imagine the mods that people would come up with for this game, because the Diablo community is a very interesting community. I can only imagine the mods that they could come up with. See, Diablo 2 had mods, unofficial of course. They had one called Meridian XXL, if I remember right. But I definitely remember it being called Meridian something. It made the game harder. More enemies made it much, much more difficult. Of course, then there was the high resolution mod, which of course, if you do any of the mods, you can't go online because you'd get banned. So of course, it was for offline mode only. Speaking of Diablo 2, I recently installed that after not playing it for a couple years. And I made a video for YouTube. See, look at that. See how my character is not even attacking? It's been doing that all day. Yeah, speaking of YouTube and making videos, you should check out my YouTube video. It's XLR416 Gaming. I don't got too many videos yet, but I got some. There's my first three videos. You can tell which one of my first three videos, because they're not that professional. I was still messing around with my NVIDIA Shadow Play. For some reason, I wasn't able to record in-game music plus my microphone for some reason. I guess it was just the way I had it set up. And so I was, the game music was muted and I just was talking. But luckily there was only a couple of videos in there. Greater Rift Keystones and some Blood Shards. We'll definitely take those Greater Rift Keystones.
I can't carry anymore.
Why can't you take those reusable parts? We'll check out the Sergeant's Core. We'll go ahead and find something to get rid of. We'll get rid of that. And then we'll try Sergeant's Core. Nothing I can use. All right, we got a Greater Rift down, so we'll go ahead and go back.
I need to go back.
Town. All right, let's see. Yeah, turn around here for a second and find a merchant. That's right, merchants are down here.
What would you like?
For you watchers wondering where I got the wings from, if you're not familiar with them, you actually get them from purchasing the Overwatch Origins Edition. You pay the $60 for it, and then you get some in-game items for Blizzard games. This and Overwatch are the only two Blizzard games I am currently playing, so So for me, that's all that I was able to use. All right, we'll do some bounties. We'll go to Fields of Misery. Oh, and if you look at my name, it says Xlar, because I am actually currently just the other day. Matter of fact, when I say other day, I mean literally just yesterday. I had made a clan and a community, Xlar 416 Gaming. So please check that out. And try to join my my clan and my community, please. I'd appreciate it. And if you're wondering what my channel is going to be about, what my clan and community is about, since I'm basically I unlocked the Paragon Portrait. Since I am basically more so a casual gamer, I'm not so hardcore like I used to be when I was younger. So,
you dare attack me?
What my clan
I don't have enough arcane power.
Would be about is helping out new people, power leveling them, giving them advice. They just want some help beating a boss. That's what we're going to be there for. Somebody's bored, don't really want to game by themselves. You know, look up somebody in my community or my clan. And, we'll give you a hand. Okay, get one bounty down. Well, we killed 80 enemies. Oh, that wasn't a very good chest. I think I'm gonna go back to town for a second. For you watchers that are huge fans of Diablo and just can't get enough of it, and you just wonder what games out there are like Diablo, there's games like Torchlight 2 and Torchlight 1, which are actually made by people who worked in Blizzard North. Some of the people that branched off from the original Diablo had actually made that. Fate is another good series.
I have some new items that I like. You know the true quality of my
which I found
ways.
Out recently that some old members of Blizzard North had made Fate as well. And then Titan Quest. Yeah, I need to go through my inventory and just wipe out everything, because I just got too much stuff. Stuff that seemed like it was worth it at the beginning. You know, and now I'm getting better stuff. So I got a lot of stuff that's just outdated. All right, let's go to Weeping Hollow. Templar Inquisition, free the villagers captured by the Templar. I did this one the other day.
These lands are wild with fear.
If they get the same layout. Yep, I was gonna say if they get the same layout, there's gonna be one over here. Get back here, I'm not done killing you. I'm not familiar with the death breath does. I've collected lots of them. So if anybody watching, please leave a comment. Let me know what the death breath does. I'm sure it's just an ingredient in something, but I'd kind of like to know what it goes for. Let's see what gets in my way. Alright, that's one villager. I'm like hitting nothing. I don't know what's going on, but my attacking has been horrible. Well, there's a goblin. I'm not going to go after it because there won't be a Ministeries goblin. Menagerie's goblin. All right, we got a helm. Legendary helm. Okay, we got villager number two. It's a blood thief. We'll take out a blood thief. One time I actually got lucky enough and I actually found one of those goblins that takes you to Whimsdale. Didn't find the queen or princess for the cosmic wings. Would have been nice though. For you though who are looking for cosmic wings, there is communities out there that that do look for nothing but cosmic wings. It's a good thing that there are communities out there in Diablo 3 that you can join, and they'll help you look for something if you want to, I don't know, just look for the cosmic wings. There's people, that's all they do. Yeah. reminds me, for you that play, if you ever come across the Cosmic Wings, please join, please invite your friends into your game and let them get the Cosmic Wings too. Or if you ever find the Falcon Wings or anything like that, you know, just don't forget to invite your friends into your party. We'll go to the Orcs Manor Courtyard. Kill. Okay, we'll enter Leorx Manor. Almost looks like Leorx Helm. Yep, Leorx Crown right there. Watching a video the other day, somebody actually was showing, it was White Locks. Please check out his channel, White Locks, on YouTube. He was showing where to find ingredients, and he was showing that down here, sometimes there's the Orc's bone. I forget what the ingredient was for. You had to get like a ton of ingredients to make something. That's something I haven't got too much into yet, like new ingredients.
Didn't see that coming, did you?
So my mage, my wizard, she really cleans house on these skeletons. Morgan Leday, but right now we're taking out Haynes. Good old explosions. Okay, we took out 75.
You dare attack me?
Okay. Alright, let's see. Go over here to the blacksmith. We'll go to Caverns Verne. That's the first time I've came here where I didn't have to kill Erne. Looks like we're going the right way. For you watching, let me know what you think your favorite class is in Diablo 3. I like the Wizard and the Demon Hunter. I mean, I like all the classes. But I have to say Wizard and Demon Hunter are probably my favorite. Witch Doctor. I like the Witch Doctor. We got 100 enemies taken care of. Now we need to find Venomite. Go to Hall's Agony, level 3. Yep, you gotta love it when you get one little enemy come up out of nowhere and get you.
Yeah.
For you watchers that are still actively playing Diablo 2, let me know what you think of Diablo 3 compared to Diablo 2. I find Diablo 3 easier to play than Diablo 2. Life regeneration, we'll definitely take life regeneration. Run through here a little bit.
I don't have enough arcane power.
One of my characters has a goblin that goes around and picks up the white weapons. And every 13 he picks up, he changes it into legendary. It's a Nagel ring that he's got that does that.
I am so good. I astound myself. I'm currently playing on hard mode. I've tried playing harder difficulties, but I could bump it up to expert. But I just don't. I don't know, I like playing on hard mode. I don't know how well my character would actually do on Torment. I have a Crusader that I used to play in Torment. Yeah, I just don't see how people playing Torment level 10 and actually one shot kill everything. I don't see how people get their characters so powerful.
Yeah.
All right. Go back to Tristram.
I need to go back.
I have some new items that I'm certain you'll love.
For you who've never played the bounty yet in adventure mode, or if you just have the regular Diablo 3 without the expansion and you're thinking about getting the expansion and you're not 100% sure if it's worth it, well, this is when you do the bounties, you talk
well,
Tyrael.
Here is your reward. You have finished all the bounties here.
You get a Hordex stash. Or Herodric's cash, you right click that and you get a bunch of stuff. Like, here's some plans for Mantle of Rhydrum, Condrum Rune.
Thank you for coming here.
35,000 gold
to undertake nearby.
So we're gonna go over here to the blacksmith. Right-click onto that. That's a jewelry design. Yeah, pick up your gems, because when you get high enough up in levels, you go over here and talk to Covetous Shen. And then you can combine gems, and you get like this Imperial Amethyst, where if you put in your weapon, 7,500 health, life per hit, helm, 20% life, other 100% vitality. Same thing with Imperial Diamonds. Because the best you can pick up is like this stuff, like the Flawless Square. Excuse me. I need to go through here and get rid of all my flawless amethyst. I was keeping them. Same thing with all these flawless rubies and stuff. I was kind of keeping them for just in case I had a weapon that was like so-so that I knew I was going to keep very, very long. Just throw one of those gems in there for a little extra boost. And now that I can craft, you know, like the good gems and stuff like that, because I got enough money, I can craft gems. Yeah, I need to go through there and get rid of all those crappy gems. Yeah, I need to go through here and sort out all my stash. I am looking for something. Probably right in front of my face. Yep, there it is. Death breath. Well, I think that's going to be all for me now for this video. I don't want to drag it out too long. Please leave in the comments what you thought of this video. Please subscribe and look for more content from me and XLR Gaming, XLR416 Gaming, here in the future. You should start seeing more videos from us, me, in the future here on Twitch. All right, thank you. And I should be posting a video here in a few days on the new season of Diablo 3, like a lot of other people are probably going to be doing. So please look forward, look for me on the 21st when season 8 starts, and I will be streaming that day. I'm not sure when, but I will be streaming at some point that day. All right. Thank you.